Hi, this is Chef Mick from Tony's Markets, working on chilies today for my container garden. Start with a jalapeno here. I'm going to cut the ends off this, peel it off really nice. We'll get this chopped up. Ideally, you want to get the white parts out and the seeds out as much as you possibly can. That's where the extra heat is. So I've got some already chopped here. Going to make a salsa. A little bit into the pot here with some mango. You know, tomatoes are great. I would normally make a tomato salsa, but today I want to make tropical. So I've got mangoes. I've got a little banana, coconut, pineapple, all that would be really good too. I have some tomato, so I'm gonna give it a little bit of color. We'll throw some of that in, and some cilantro. And then red onion is so nice in this. Here's a little trick with the onion. You slice it down almost to the end, get nice little slivers here, and then we come back and we can slice it really fine. Or in this case, I want a little bit longer pieces, so I'm gonna cut it in little segments like this. These will be great in the salsa. Okay, this, a little bit of salt. And pepper. We'll toss this together with a little bit of, okay, maybe a lot of olive oil. And a little shot of lime juice. Get fresh lime juice. I like to use key lime juice, really delicious. Toss this together. You could also add a little bit of sugar or agave syrup to this, but this should be perfect. When we come back, we're gonna make jalapeno mashed potatoes with a nice piece of grilled fish and top it off with this salsa. Hi, this is Chef Mick from Tony's Markets. We've got our salsa ready. Now we're gonna get some fish ready for the grill here. To start out with a sprinkle, I'm gonna use one of my rubs here. I've got a couple of different choices. You could use this chili arriba, or you could use this Tokyo rub. Either one is great. If you don't have these, a little salt and pepper would be fine, or any of your favorite seasoning blends. And then we gotta get the fan on. Got a nice hot grill pan here. Give it a little spray of oil. You could also just do this on the grill outside. We'll go ahead and get this on and let this cook. We're gonna give this about 10 minutes for every inch of thickness. So we'll be back in about 10 minutes for this. A little while ago, I started these potatoes. I got boiling water, I put whole potatoes in here. They need about 40 or 50 minutes to get fully cooked. And the last couple minutes, I'm gonna throw in jalapenos. Peel them, seed them, throw them right in there with them. We're gonna let those blanch for about 60, 90 seconds. And our fish is ready to turn over here. Ah, beautiful. Okay, that's long enough. Take these out. I'm gonna cool these off and chop them up. And I'm just gonna slice these up to little pieces. And mince them fine. All right, we've got our potatoes. These cooked for probably about 45, 50 minutes. What you want to do is you want to pierce them with a knife or a fork, and if they fall off easily, they're done. That's how you tell if they're done. And they've stayed together really nice, so they haven't gotten watery. Take my little masher here, just bust them up a little bit. I've done them smashed, but you can also take off the skins and put them in the food mixer. I'm gonna throw in some butter. One is good, two taste better. And then I've got some milk or half and half or cream, and I've warmed it up and I reduced it down a little bit. It gives it a little bit richer flavor. I added just a pinch of sugar to that because the sugar will help keep it from scorching. That milk scorches, it's a mess. You gotta start all over. To this, jalapenos. These aren't very hot jalapenos. I've already tasted them. Mash them in there real nice. And salt and pepper. And right at the last minute, I like to throw in some fresh garden chives. It really brightens it up a little bit and gives it a little bit more color. Now, if you're crazy about cheese, you could definitely put some cheddar cheese in here, or sour cream would be fabulous. Got the full recipe on diginColorado.com, but you can adjust. Recipe's just the guideline anyway. Got a beautiful jalapeno mashed potato. Now by blanching those, we take some of the heat out of it, and you just get a nice jalapeno flavor, but not too much heat. I'm gonna top this off with our fishes. Yeah, let's do it that way. And we're gonna garnish this with some of this jalapeno and mango salsa. We've got the recipe for this and all the recipes at diginColorado.com. Let's dig in.